Stairs. If you're not careful, they can go from healthy to harmful in an instant. Today, we're going to examine the consequences of not holding the handrail.
So Chris, you use the handrail when you take the stairs, right?
Well, of course, don't you?
All the time. Honestly, using the handrail is like second nature to me, kind of like wearing a seatbelt in the car. I did some research, and in the US alone, there's 3,000 stair-related injuries per day. That's over 1 million per year. And those range from concussions to broken hips. And sadly, 12,000 people die per year.
Wow, so how come people don't use a handrail all the time?
Well, after talking to a Black Veatch focus group, we found out there's two main reasons. One, habitual. They don't use the handrail at home, so they're not gonna use it at the office. And two, the ick factor. They think there's germs and other things on the handrail that they don't want.
Well, let's put those excuses to the test.
Like an experiment?
Oh yeah.
First up, germs. To start, our two safety experts are getting samples from handrails along with other daily objects. Once these samples are collected, they will be put to the test to see how they compare to our handrails.
All right, we've gathered our samples in the petri dishes.
Now we just need to wait and see what happens.
1 week later.
Okay, we've got our samples. Let's take a look.
Okay. Ooh, we have the cell phone first. It's got some drops on it, some bacteria. The whiteboard marker, really clean.
Yeah, it's almost like there's not even anything there.
The touch screen, surprisingly dirty.
Oh no.
Oh, I'm not touching that one.
What is that?
That's the computer mouse. I'm making Chris do it.
Oh, look at it.
Looks like moldy cheese.
That is bad.
That is extremely dirty. The worst one by far so far. The side handrail, surprisingly not too dirty. All right, the elevator button, surprisingly clean for how many times that gets touched.
Yeah, it looks pretty comparable to the side handrail.
Yep. All right, the door handle to the meeting room.
Look, look at that. No more meetings.
No more.
No more meetings.
Dun, dun, dun. That's really clean.
Looks clean. All the ones that we have, computer mouse, by far the worst.
By far.
But from a handrail side, looks pretty good.
Yeah. This is one of the cleanest surfaces in our building.
Yeah, absolutely. I totally agree.
The bacteria test results really surprised me. How about you?
Yeah, it was interesting how clean the handrail samples were compared to all the other ones that we conducted.
Where do we go from here?
Well, when it comes to changing behaviors, using neural pathway exercises is a great way to start.
Are you able to give me an example?
Yeah, let's take a look at that yellow car right there in the parking lot.
Oh, I see it.
Good. Now, if you keep that in your mind, you'll find out that you actively notice yellow cars all day long when otherwise they would have just been cars. That thought process has led to change the way you'd normally think about something. So for holding the handrail, the more you consciously think about it, the stronger those neural pathways will be.
Huh, tell me more.
Yeah, your brain is being shaped, molded, and changed by everyday experiences. This is often referred to as neuroplasticity.
Sounds like that's all someone needs to do to start changing the way they think.
Yes, but before we're done, we still have one more test to do.
I was hoping you would say that.
In this final test, the team will test how dangerous a fall is from stairs. With the help of the Overland Park Fire Department, they're about to find out.
Hi, Jay. Thank you for having us today at the training center.
No problem. Glad you guys can make it.
Jay, can you tell us a little bit about this training center?
Yeah, this is where we hold our fire and EMS training for our crews. And that's where our training mannequin comes in.
Now, does the training mannequin have a name?
Yeah, his name is Rescue Randy.
I'm definitely excited to see how he does with our demonstration.
All right, we've attached shock watches to Rescue Randy's body with different G-force sensitivities. 15 G for strains and sprains.
25 G for concussions.
37 G for broken bones.
And 50 G for fatal.
Here we go, in 3, 2, 1.
Well, going throughout the whole body, what I notice is we've got a lot of the markers that actually distinguish strains and sprains. It went off. In addition to that, we've got our purple, which delineates broken bones. And as you can see up there, also on the ankle.
3, 2, 1.
Yeah, and we've got the other markers that also indicate strains and sprains. We've got broken bones over here. I mean, we've got a whole lot of just everything going on.
And the red indicator, which shows fatal, did go off on his head. So the most devastating thing that can happen to a person did when he fell down the stairs.
So whether you're at home, in the office, or on a project, always remember to hold the handrail.